So boys, so in our yesterday's class, we completed about H3BO3, one of the boron compounds. So a lot of compounds from boron are there. So already we covered so B2O3, that is boron trioxide, and also very important compound H3BO3. That is boric acid, its preparation properties and its structure. Okay, layer-like structure, sheet-like structure. Hydrogen bonds, all those we covered, boys. Next compound from boron site, that is metaboric acid. Next compound, so boron site, please take the heading, metaboric acid. Okay, so boys, please consider today's and tomorrow's topics. What I want to cover today and tomorrow in this session, those are very, very important towards your objective side. Very, very, very important. Both today's class and tomorrow's class. So please give utmost concentration towards your listening of classes. Please, it is very, very important. So almost all our reactions, sir. All our reactions. So today and tomorrow's class is very, very important. Okay, let us start today's class. So that is metaboric acid. So its formula HBO2. Boys, already in our yesterday's class, that is H3BO3. So properties, if it, H3BO3 is heated up to 100 degrees centigrade, HBO2 is the product. If it is still heated, tetraboric acid is the product. So then heated up to red hot condition, that gives B2O3. So that is boric anhydride is the product. So these are the these reactions, once again, I am using in case of HBO2, metaboric acid. So metaboric acid. See here. So H3BO3 is heated strongly up to 100 degrees centigrade. That gives metaboric acid. This is our metaboric acid, boys. So this is the only preparation method for metaboric acid. Now, what are its properties? When metaboric acid is heated up to 160, next continuation reaction. So up to 160, that is the tetraboric acid, and heated strongly, and gives boric anhydride. So it is a continuity reactions for today's yesterday's class. Next, when metaboric acid, see here H3BO3 on heating, loss of water gives HBO2. So for HBO2, if water is added, that gives H3BO3, backward reaction. So corresponding acid is the productant, that is H3BO3 is the productant. Next, so it is acid, metaboric acid. So this metaboric acid reacts with strong base like NaOH. So sodium metaborate is the productant. It is sodium metaborate. So this is the product along with water. It is acid-base neutralization reaction. This is at acid-base neutralization reaction. Okay. So these are preparation, some properties, and all these we know. All these we know. Now, what about the existence of this metaboric acid? Sometimes a metaboric acid exists as a monomer, dimer, and a trimer, sir. So let us observe what are the structures of monomer, dimer, and trimer states of trimer molecules of this metaboric acid. So let us take the structures and please note down these equations. Please note down these equations. Now, structures and HBO2. Structures of HBO2. So as monomer, as dimer, as a trimer. See here. So HBO2, right, is just like this. Boron with OH and double bond boron. HBO2. It is a monobasic acid. But it is unstable, boys. It is converted into dimer. It is monomer condition. It is as monomer. Now, if it exists as dimer, see here, OH, B, it is double bond O, one more end. Dimer means, so two molecules unite with each other. So boron, so double bond O with OH. So these are two HBO3 molecules. So rearranged, this pi bond is moved to here, and this pi bond is here. So two bridge oxygens are possible. It is the dimer structure of metaboric acid and dimer. Dimeric structure. Dimeric structure of metaboric acid, dimeric form. Next, a trimeric form. And similarly, three molecules you should take. So that is boron with OH, double bond O. Boron with OH, double bond O. Boron, OH, double bond O. Three metaboric acids, trimerized ring. So see here, this bond to this one, this bond to this one, this bond to this one. So it is a trimeric form. Trimeric form of metaboric acid. So these are the three existences of monomeric form, dimeric form, and trimeric bond. Yes, 3 centered 4 electron bonds, no doubt. Okay, so trimeric bond, these are possible. And here bridge oxygens are available. Bridge oxygens are available. Okay, so now, so a note point, please note down the structure of tetrametaboric acid. Tetrametaboric acid, a structure. So sometimes, at one time, that structure is asked, boys. So that's why I'm representing here, tetrametaboric acid, 4 metaboric acids, tetrametaboric acids. See here, note point boys, structure of tetra meta boric acid. Structure of tetra meta boric acid. See here how to write. So take boric acid, not meta boric acid. I am taking boric acid, boys. So B OH OH OH. One boric acid. Next. OH, OH, OH. Second boric acid. Next. B, OH, OH, OH. Third molecule. Next. B, OH, OH, OH. Fourth molecule. These are 4 molecules, boys. Now, see. So during heating, water molecules are lost. See here. So this is water loss, running H2O. Next, H2O loss. Next, H2O loss. Next, H2O loss. Next, H2O loss. Total 5 water molecules lost, boys. Okay, so after that, what is the final structure? So the final structure is like this. See here, 4 borons, boron bonded with oxygen, boron bonded with oxygen, boron bonded with oxygen, boron bonded with oxygen, boron. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Octacarbonate. So 8 carbons left. So these 2 borons have 2 OH groups. So these borons are also linked with oxygen. So this is the tetrametaboric acid. It is tetrametaboric acid formula. Very, very, very important. So here, so oxygen bridge structures are, bridge bonds are available. So bridge oxygens are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bridge oxygens. All borons BOB bonds are available. No BB direct link is available. BB direct bonds are not possible any. BO bonds are there. BOH. So it is from this hydrogen, from this OH, hydrogen is evolved any. So therefore it is a 1 plus 1 dibasic acid. It is a dibasic acid. It is tetrametaboric acid. Please keep in mind. So remaining water molecules, no doubt. So plus water molecules. During heating, that water is lost any. It is the final acid. It is the final formant. Okay, all those water molecules are lost. So to explain the structure, how this is formed, I am representing like that. So not directly, I am representing that. So derived, the structure is derived, boys, by the elimination of water. Okay, so it is a, okay. Now, next and very, very important compound, boys, that is borax. Very, very, very important. Borax. Next, Savadi. Fifth compound, borax. Borax, which is also called as or sodium tetraborate. Sodium tetraborate. So it is a chemical name for that borax. It's a formula. Formula Na2B4O7 10H2O. Na2B4O7 10H2O. That is decahydrated. Decahydrate. Okay. So it is commonly called as borax. Sir, how to prepare this borax? Borax, no doubt, it is available from our earthquake voice. So impure form of borax is called as tincal. Note on the first point. Impure form of borax is called as tincal, which is available in our nature. So first point. From preparation condition, preparation, impure borax is called as a tin call. Impure borax is called as tin call. This tin call, nothing but borax, is extracted from lake water by sedimentation. So that means the solids are separated and filtered, boys. So by sedimentation. So lake water, lake mud, that is sedimented, during sedimentation process, this tin call is collected. So how, sir? How? So boys, this borax, so generally less soluble in cold water and more soluble in hot water. So that means almost we observe. So see here. So next point, that is, so at 0 degree centigrade, observation, at 0 degree centigrade, 100 grams water, particularly lake water, can dissolve 1.3 grams tin colony. So that means 100 grams water can dissolve 1.3 grams tin call, nothing but borax. Borax. It is better to go with borax. So see here, at 100 degree centigrade, same 100 grams water can dissolve 103 grams borax. It is observed fact, boys. That means borax is less soluble at low temperatures and more soluble in high temperatures. That is why at high temperatures that water is collected in, because in that situation more borax is there. Now that borax is slowly cooled down and crystallized, so automatically that soluble borax, because of temperature decreases, precipitated as a crystallized form. So those crystals we will collect. So those crystals are nothing but that is tin call or borax, and then purified. So that is why, so it is the sedimentation process. From sedimentation of lake water, this borax is prepared. See here. So generally,
generally, no doubt, generally, borax is collected from hot water and filtering slowly and filtering slowly by cooling it, because during cooling, so that is precipitated out. So by cooling, so borax crystals are formed. These crystals are separated. So these borax crystals are separated and then purified. So this is the way. So from lake water. So this is from lake water by sedimentation process. By sedimentation process from lake water, this borax is prepared. This borax is separated. Not prepared, it is separated. So at hot water, at hot condition, more borax is dissolved boys. So that water, hot water is slowly cooled down and separated out. So at low temperature, borax is prepared. This is the way to prepare that thing called or borax. Boys, yesterday at the time of preparation of that B2O3 or H3BO3, okay? So from calamine, so borax is prepared. There is one of the methods, boys. Already we covered it. That's why I'm not representing here. So from calamine also, borax is prepared. So already we completed yesterday. Okay. So these are the preparation methods. Now, this prepared, this crystallized borax at different conditions, different allotropic forms are available. Borax also contains allotropes. So at different temperatures, different allotropic crystals are obtained, boys. Please see, that is note on the point, that is, so if it is crystallized at 30 degrees centigrade, the obtained borax has the general formula Na2B4O7 10H2O. If this is crystallized at 30 degrees centigrade, the obtained borax has this formula in it. So this is called as ordinary borax. This is nothing but ordinary borax or prismatic borax, one of the allotropic forms. This is called as prismatic borax or ordinary borax, which is crystallized at 30 degrees centigrade. If it is at 60 degrees centigrade, that means temperature increases, boys. Some of the water molecules are evaporated in it. So up to from 10H2O, only 5H2O is removed in it. So that is crystallized at 60 degrees centigrade, the formula is Na2B4O7 5H2O is the product ending, which is called as Jewellers borax or octahedral borax, which is called as Jewellers borax or octahedral borax. Another allotropic form of borax. So borax also has different allotropes, boys. There is prismatic borax, octahedral borax. Prismatic borax is nothing but ordinary borax. It is the formula. So it is octahedral borax. It is the formula. If still heated, so that is up to red hot condition. Still heated. Now all those five water molecules are lost. That is anhydride form is formed in it. Na2B4O7. This is also represented as 2NaBO2 plus B2O3. So both are same. 2NaBO2 plus B2O3, which is nothing but Na2B4O7. Na2B4O7. Okay. So now, which is called as borax glass.
That is a borax glass. That means at 30 degrees centigrade, prismatic borax exists. At 60 degrees centigrade, heated. So not possible, boys. It is red hot. That means the available mass is going to be red. There, anhydrous substance is formed. So no need of temperature conditions. No need of temperature. Okay, that means almost more than 100, maybe. Okay, so at ordinary condition, at 30 degrees, almost room temperature, any prismatic borax heated up to 60 degrees centigrade, octahedral borax, and still heated up to red hot condition, borax gas. What is the formula for borax gas? That is Na2B4O7R, which is also rewritten as NaBO2 plus B2O. That means borax is nothing but it is a compound of sodium metaborate. Sodium metaborate. That means borax is the salt of metaboric acid, not tetraboric acid. It is not a salt of tetraboric acid. It is a salt of metaboric acid. Even the formula contains tetraborate. Even though name contains tetraborate, but it is the salt of metaboric acid. It is very, very important. Borax is the salt of metaboric acid. Okay, next. Twice. This compound has no water molecules. It is highly hygroscopic and absorbs water vapor. Highly hygroscopic. So because of that, it is almost, so when it is absorbed water vapor from atmosphere, then converts into decahydrate condition. Original form will be available. So see here, so note point, that is borax glass. Borax glass is hygroscopic. Borax glass is hygroscopic, absorbs water and converts into decahydrate. So, okay. So, this is about the preparation of borax. Now, what are the properties of this borax? The properties of borax. So, note on these points. These are very, very, very important points, boys, about borax. Next, properties. So borax is the salt of metaboric acid. Please note on that point. It is important. So first point, it is the salt of metaboric acid. Not tetraboric acid, boys. It is the salt of metaboric acid because when it is dissolved in water, so metaboric acid is formed in it. Not tetraboric acid. That's why it is considered as metaboric acid salt. So next one. Second point. So it is moderately soluble in cold water. No doubt. It is moderately soluble in cold water. But highly soluble in hot water. That means as temperature increases, solubility of this salt also increases in. Next point. That is our formula Na2B4O7. This is our tetraborate, that is sodium tetraborate or borax. If the sodium tetraborate is dissolved in water, see, observe this, dissolved in water, that gives, first of all, so Na combination with NaOH, 2NaOH plus, so that is H2B4O7. tetraboric acid. Then the tetraboric acid still reacts with NaOH and dissolved in water. See here, that tetraboric acid H2B4O7. H2B4O7. So still dissolved in water. That is, it is 2H2O. That gives, still dissolved in water, that gives 4H3BO3. That means, so total summation, these two are cancelled. Now, Na2B4O7 plus 9H2O plus, just it is 5, right? It is 5, it is 7. So 7H2O gives, so 2NaOH plus 4H3BO3. Boys, it is a strong base. It is weak acid. It is a strong base, it is weak acid. That means when sodium tetraborate is dissolved in water, that gives NaOH and H3BO3. So that means the final solution is basic in nature. And therefore, see here. Let us continue our topic. That is, this NaOH still reacts with H3BO3. So that is, NaOH reacts with H3BO3. That gives H3BO3. That gives, so NaBO2 2NaBO2, 2NaOH. So 2NaBO2 plus still unreacted H3BO3, unreacted H3BO3 plus water is the productant. Yes. So therefore, final solution contains, this is the solvent. Unreacted H3BO3, because a little solid reacted it. Unreacted H3BO3, NaBO2. It is a salt of weak acid and strong base, and it is weak acid. Weak acid and it's a salt with a strong base. Therefore, this mixture itself acts as acidic buffer. That means our borax aqua solution behaves like acidic buffer. So therefore, aqua solution of borax is nothing but acidic buffer. Acidic buffer. So okay, so it is acidic buffer solution. Next, aqua solution wise, it is very, very important. Aqueous borax solution is basic in nature. Basic in nature, because borax is the combination of weak acid and it's salt with strong weak acid and strong base. Final solution contains basic in nature because of anionic hydrolysis. Basic in nature due to anionic hydrolysis. Due to anionic hydrolysis, it is basic in nature. Therefore, pH greater than 7. So, aqueous borax solution, pH greater than 7, because it is basic in nature due to anionic hydrolysis. Anionic hydrolysis. So, that is our salt hydrolysis concept is applied. Our salt hydrolysis concept is applied. Finally, our aqueous solution acts as acidic buffer. And finally, solution becomes basic in nature. Basic solution is formed. Basic solution is formed. Next, another property. Another property, that is, when borax Na2B4O7 reacts with ammonium chloride, that gives 2NaBO2 plus, just a minute, that is boron nitride plus B2O3 plus NaCl plus H2O. NaCl plus H2O. These are the products. It is 2 times, it is 4 times. So that means, so it is a boronite. It is the most important compound, boys, from a boron site. Boron nitride is the product. So these are some chemical properties. And most important reaction is that is borax beam test. So that is, I'm going to explain the concept that is very, very, very important. Borax bead test. Next property of borax, that is fifth one, any fifth property. That is fifth property, borax bead testing. Borax bead test. What is this borax bead test? Where it is used? For what purpose? So in qualitative analysis, this test is used. Right? Qualitative analysis to identify the transition metal ions. To identify transition metal ions. First point. To identify transition metal ions present in the given salt. In qualitative analysis, this test is conducted. This test is used. This test is used to identify, very, very important, transition metal ions. Not all metal ion coils. Only D block metal ions. Those gives colors. Okay. Only transition metal ions identification, this test is conducted. So what is this, sir? So do the given salt, if it may contains, that is our transition metal is mixed with some borax and heated strongly. What happened? First of all, boron on heating gives swells in because it loses water in and becomes anhydride. First of all, it swells. After that, it converts into strong heating. It converts into borax glass. Borax glass. Okay? That is a transparent glassy solid. So see here. So during this process, when borax heated, when borax heated, come on, it loses water and swells. So because of loss of water, it's going to be swells in. So and swells and becomes and swells and so losses water and swells and crystallizes. And just a minute. So losses water and swells and crystallizes. And crystallizes. And crystallizes, boys. So that means when borax is heated, so it loses its water molecules and crystallizes in the form of anhydrous. Because of the loss of water, it's going to be swelling it. So swelling nature is available on the surface of that borax, anhydride borax. Now it is heated strongly. At high temperature, it melts and turns into transparent glassy bead. Transparent glassy bead. Okay. So how, sir? That means because of that borax glass. See here what happened. That is Na2B4O7 is heated strongly, boys. Is heated strongly and becomes finally 2NaBO2+B2O3. It is nothing but borax glass. This borax glass has transparent glassy bead. It is a transparent glassy bead. So during heating, already our metal salt also there any. So that metal salt reacts with this B2O3. That metal salt in the form of metal oxide and reacts with this formed B2O3 and gives colored bead. See here, I'm taking a cobalt salt is taken. So that cobalt oxide, it is from salt. From salt, cobalt oxide during heating. So the salt becomes oxide and that B2O3, that B2O3, these two combination gives CO, cobalt, BO2 twice. CO, BO2 twice. That compound is formed. It is called as cobalt metaborate. So because of formation of this metaborate with our complex metals, so this has blue in color. Blue colored bead. So if cobalt is there, the color of the bead is blue. If blue color is there, then the transition metal ions must be a cobalt ion. Cobalt ion. That means based on the color of the bead formed in this case, we can identify which metal ion, which transition metal ion present in your given salts. So this is the way to identify that metal ion, transition metal ion present in your given salt wise. So here borax is used, that's why it is called as borax bead test because a colored bead is formed. So different metals gives different colors. Different metals gives different colored beads. Okay. If you want to find out what are the color of different metal beads, so please go and search in your integrated booklet. In your integrated book at borax bead test. So different metal boys. Here the compound is metaborate boys. Metaborates, metal metaborates are the production. Cobalt metaborate, copper metaborate, nickel metaborate, all those metaborates are formed. Those metaborates has different colors. Those metaborates. So they're based on the color, we can identify the which transition metal. So boys, please go and write metal beads colors from your integrated book. So please go follow integrated book for this case. For other metals, colors and other metals, colors of other metal beads. Okay, so that is, it is borax bead test. It is borax bead test. Very, very, very important test. Very, very important test. So here, the bead is metaborate. Metal metaborate is the bead. Any that metal metaborate has, so that metal metaborate has different colors. First of all, boys, borax and our salt are together heated. Together heated. First of all, borax like this. And salt, any salt becomes respect to oxide. If copper sulfate is there, copper oxide is the product. So during heating, copper sulfate becomes copper oxide. So metal sulfide given, they are converted into metal oxide. So borax gives borax glass and our salt gives metal oxide. So that from borax oxide, borax glass, B2O3, our metal oxide, these two collectively involved in the reaction. All these are simultaneous reactions. So finally, we have this colored bead. Finally, we have this colored bead. So based on the color, we can identify which is the metal ion present in that solid. Particularly, it is applicable only for transition metal ions. This is the test only for transition metal ions. No other metal ions. So alkali metals, alkaline earth metals are not identified by this test. Only applicable for transition metal ions. Okay. So this is about borax bead test. Now, what is the structure of metaborate ion? Next one, structure of metaborate ion. It is also very, very important. So structure of tetraborate ion, not metaborate, it is a tetraborate. Structure of tetraborate ion, boys. So what do we know? That is, we know borax. Borax. What is this borax? Na2, B4, O7, 10H2O. This is, I am rewriting, boys, like this.
It is nothing but Na2, B4, O5, OH4 times 8H2O. Both these same boys, Na2, B4, O7, 10H2O is 100% equal to Na2, B4, O5, OH4 times 8H4. See, observe, Na2, Na2, B4, B4. Ora, here 7 plus 10, 17 oxygens ra. 5 plus 4, 9, 9 plus 8, 17 oxygens ra. Hydrogens ra, 4 plus 16, 20 ra. 10 into 2, 20 ra. Everyone is there. So this is rewritten like this. Okay. Now, this box ion is called as metaborate ion. Sorry, tetraborate ion. This box ion is called as tetraborate ion. This box is called as tetraborate ion. Now, I am trying to draw this structure. So, it splits into two Na plus ions plus B4O5OH4 times minus 2 ion plus 8 water molecule. These 8 water molecules associated with these two Na plus ions. Those 8 water molecules associated with Na plus ions. That is hydrated ones. So, 2 Na plus ions hydrated with those 8 water molecules. This ion is called as tetraborate ion. Now, I am trying to draw the structure of this tetraborate ion. Structure of tetraborate. See here. So, 4 borons tetrahedrally arranged. 4 borons tetrahedrally arranged. 5 oxygens. So, a bridge between boron and boron with oxygen. With oxygen, a bridge formed. Four oxygens completed. This is our fifth oxygen. Okay. Four borons, five oxygens completed. Next, four OHs. Each boron is bonded with OH. Each boron bonded with OH. Okay. So, this is about the structure of tetraborate ion. It is the structure of a tetraborate ion. See here. So, here. This boron has four bonds. So that's why actually boron can form three bonds. And fourth bond is there. That's why this boron has negative charge. Next, this boron has four bonds. This boron has negative charge. That is a minus two charge. Minus two charge. For one minus, another minus. Next, boys, here boron can give three bonds only. So now this boron is in sp2 hybridization. This boron is in sp2 hybridization. This boron also in sp2 hybridization. But this boron four bonds. Now this boron is in sp3 hybridization. This boron also in sp3 hybridization. That means in tetraborate ion, all borons are not in the same hybridization. Two borons sp2 hybridized. Two borons sp3 hybridized. Two borons sp2 hybridized. Two borons sp3 hybridized. From this structure, what I am trying to explain, that is first point here, two borons sp2 hybridized and trigonal planar shaken. So trigonal planar shaken. Next, two more borons are there. Those are sp3 hybridized. They are tetrahedral shaped. Those are tetrahedral shaped. Here no BB bond is there. B bonded with B. Number of bonds is equal to 0. So BB direct bond is not possible at any variant. So direct bonds are not available, boys. Next, here, 8 water molecules associated with two Na plus ions. 8 water molecules associated with two Na plus ions, boys. Next, observe this. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is a 6 member ring. It is a 6 member ring. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is also a 6 member ring, boys. So in this structure, how many 6 member rings are there? 2 6 member rings are there. So here, 2 six-membered rings are available. Rings are present. Two six-membered rings are present. So these are the points, very, very, very important points. So these are from, so tetraboridionic. So these are, so totally, so two sp2 hybridized and two sp2 hybridized. Next point. So total minus is minus 1 plus minus 1 minus 2. So total negative charge is equal to. Yes, yes, Kartikeya, please wait. So total negative charge minus 2. Total number of sp3 hybrid hybridized also 2 only. Negative charge is 2. sp3 hybrid borons are also 2 only. Therefore, that is number of tetrahedral borons is equal to, so number of charges on the ion. Number of tetrahedral borons is equal to number of, so tetrahedral boron has only charge any. That's why more the tetrahedral borons, more is the charge. More rate than negative charge. See boys, so this is one ring end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is a six-member ring. This is also another ring, boy. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 end. Another ring end. That means this structure contains two six-member rings end. Two six-member rings. Okay? So this is about the structure of tetraborate ion. Very, very, very important. Very, very important, boys. It is the structure of tetraborate ion. Okay, no hydrogen bonds here, boys. No hydrogen bonds are available. Okay, so this is tetraborate ion. Now, what are the uses of this borax? See here. Uses of borax. Uses of borax. First point, used as acidic buffer. Used as acidic buffer. Already I explained, boys. Used as acidic buffer. Next, it is used in the manufacture of artificial glass, paper, artificial glass, paper, soap, enamel. Next, leather, etc. So next point, third point. So in metallurgy, as a flux, and also at the time of soldering, it is used as a flux. So in metallurgy as a flux, and in soldering also, which is also as a flux end. Next point, okay, as an antiseptic, in boric lotions, So these are some important points, and most important one is very, very, very important point. That is, when B2O3, this B2O3 coming from borax boys in borax glass, when B2O3, when dissolved in H2O2, B2O3 when dissolved in H2O2 forms perboric acid. So B2O3 when dissolved in H2O2 forms perboric acid. Very, very, very important. If B2O3 dissolved in water gives boric acid. If B2O3 dissolved in hydrogen peroxide, that gives perboric acid. What is this structure? See here. That is boron. So these are the two borons, boys. It is OH, OH. This one also bonded with OH and OH. So this is perboric acid, perborate ion, perboric acid. So this boron with it is, see boys, what we observe, that is this one four bonds, right? That is why it gets negative charge. This one also four bond, this one gets negative charge. It is sp3 hybridized. It is also sp3 hybridized. Both the borons are in sp3 hybridization. Next, this is one peroxy bond, this is another peroxy bond. So two peroxy bonds are available. So that is a peroxy bond. So two peroxy bonds, total two, one total two peroxy bonds are there. In peroxy bond, oxygen has minus one oxidation state. In peroxy bonds, each oxygen has minus one oxygen state. Here boron has plus three oxygen state. Here also boron has a plus three oxygen state. Boron oxygen state is plus three. Oxygens, four oxygens have minus one oxygen state. Here, first point, oxidation state of boron is equal to plus three. Next, oxidation state of oxygen, which is four oxygens have minus one and four oxygens have minus two. So these four oxygens have minus two oxygen state. These four oxygens have minus one oxygen state. Next, two peroxy links or peroxy bonds are possible. Two peroxy links or peroxy bonds are possible. Okay. Next, hybridization of boron is equal to sp3. Hybridization of boron is equal to sp3. So these are the important points from this point wise. Next, this is rewritten as like this, sir. So this is rewritten as like this. See here, B2, O2, O2, O2 twice, because it is peroxy bond, any B2, O2 twice, OH four times minus two iron. This is perborate iron. So the name of this one is perborate ion. Perborate ion. It is the structure of perborate ion, boys. It is the structure of perborate ion. So this is used. So it is used. I am writing here. It is used in it is used as a brightener. It is used as a brightener in washing purpose, in cloth washing, in washing purpose. So in washing purpose, the washing purpose or process, it is better process. In washing process, it is used as a brightener. It is important. It is used as a brightener. So these are all some important uses of our borax. These are all important uses of borax. Boys, did you catch my point? So these are the important points. So it is important, boys. So perboric acid and perborate ion. So if it loses two hydrogen H plus ions, ion is formed, that ion is called as perborate ion.
both carboric acids losing a H plus ions gives a negative ion. That negative ion is called as perborate ion. So that is ion from perboric acid. That is ion with perboric acid. That is from carboric acid. Okay. So this is boric acid and its uses. So every point is important, boys. Every point is important. Now let us discuss about the hydrides of boron. Next subheading and sixth component, that is boron compound side. Sixth compound, that is boron hydrides. Subheading it. Next subheading, boron hydrides. That means our boron with hydrogen, the compounds are called as boron hydrides. And boron with hydrogen, the compounds are called as boron hydrides. Here, so two types of hydrides are formed, boys. Already we explained at the time of hydrides of 13th group elements. So boron can form two types of hydrides. One is the nidohydrides, and the what is the second one? Tell me. What is the second one? Nidohydrides, and the second one is. Tell me, boys. Waiting for you. Types of yes, Sudhan, you are correct. Seshan, correct. Yes, arachinohydrides. So boys, boron can form two types of hydrides. All are covalent in nature. Boron can form two types of hydrides. All are covalent in nature. What are those two types? That is first one, that is nidohydrides. Nidohydrides, general formula BnHn plus 4n. It is a general formula for nidohydrides. Sorry, nidoborates, not hydrides. It is borates. Nidoborates. And next, second one, arachinoborates. So it's a general formula BnHn plus 6n. So nidoborates and arachinoborates. Nidoborates, these are less stable. So nidoborates are more stable and arachinoborates are less stable. Let us observe different examples twice. See here. So examples. So from nidoborates, put n is equal to 2, that is B2H6. Simply called as it is a diborane. So it is a diborane. Next, B5H5+4, 9. H9, it is 5 borons, pentaborane. Pentaborane. Next, B6, hydrogen, that is 10, and hexaborane. Pentaborane, hexaborane. Like this are possible, boys. Now, here arachinoborates. Here, examples. First arachinoborane is B4. First one is B4. B4, H10N. It is tetraborane. Tetraborane. Next, B5. B5 means H11N. That is pentaborane. Pentaborane. Next, B6N, H6+6, 12N. That is hexaborane. Next, B10, 10+6, H16. That is decaborane. These are the products, boys. But see here, B5H9 pentaborate, B5H11 pentaborate, both the two different compounds have same name in it. So that's why it is not possible. To distinguish these two names, to distinguish these two compounds, so at the at last in the brackets mention the hydrogen numbers. It is 9. It is a pentaborane 9. 9 indicates 9 hydrogens are there. Next, here pentaborane 11. So therefore, now names are different. It is a pentaborane 9, it is pentaborane 11. Similarly, here also hexaborane 12, it is a decaborane 16. That means at the last in the brackets, those hydrogen numbers should be mentioned. So tetraborane, no tetraborane here. That is why. So no need of hydrogen mentioning it. But so in remaining cases, there should be hydrogen, number of hydrogens must be mentioned in brackets. Here also that. So C6, hexaborane 10. So these are the exact names of these molecules. Among all these borates, the simplest borane is diborane. It is the simplest borane. This is in our syllabus. From borates, so in our syllabus, diborane is the only example. Yes, only that one is available in it. That means its preparation, its properties, its uses, its other compounds, all those we should learn here. Okay, now subheading diborane. Yes. Okay, Raja. Thank you. At last we will discuss. Okay. Boys, diborane is the first most important compound from 13th group elements. It is a very, very, very important topic. 100% guarantee question from this diborane concept. So please be conscious. So its preparation, its properties, its structure, its uses, and some other compounds from this diborane. What I want to tell, everything is important. Number of reactions, all are reactions. Please don't go panicking. So please write all these equations. Okay? So now I'm trying to explain preparation of this diborane. That is, so diborane, first one, preparation. That is from metal borides. So metal borides, first one, from metal boride, magnesium bromide, Mg3B2. It is magnesium boride. If this magnesium boride is hydrolyzed gives a mixture of borane sand. So this magnesium boride is hydrolyzed, that gives a mixture of borane sand. What are those? B2H6 plus B4H10 plus B5H9N. So these are the mixture of borates are available, boys. It is not possible to separate the diborate. That is why this method is not useful to prepare only diborate. So therefore, it is not useful. But one of the products is diborate. Next, second preparation method. Second one, that is from boron trifluoride or boron trichloride. So that is 4BF3 and reacts with lithium aluminium hydride, LiAlH4 three times. That gives B2H6 plus
LiF plus AlF3. B2H6 plus LiF plus AlF3. 3 LiF, it is 2 B2H6, 3 LiF, 3 AlF3. Similarly, 4 BCl3 reacts with 3 LiAlH4. Same reaction, 2 B2H6 plus 3 LiCl plus 3 AlCl3. So both are same, any either the boron trifluoride or boron trichloride are used. Next, third preparation method. So when iodine reacts with the sodium borohydride, that is 2NaBH4, sodium borohydride. So reacts with the sodium borohydride, that gives, so NaI plus B2H6 plus B2H6, NaI plus B2H6 plus H2N. Hydrogen gas is liberated, it is 2NaI. 2NaI plus B2H6 plus H2 are the production. So it is the way to prepare diborane. Here is diborane. Okay, so this is the third preparation method. Next, fourth one. When boron trifluoride, that is BF3, reacts with metal hydrides, that is 6NaH, a little. So that is a sodium hydride, reacts with sodium hydride, that gives B2H6 plus NaF are the production. NaF. So 6NaF. It is a diborane. Similarly, when BCl3 reacts with lithium hydride, 2BCl3, 2LiH, that gives B2H6 plus 6LiCl. Both are same type reaction boys. So when trihalides are used to prepare B2H6, diborane preparation. Okay, next, fifth one, that is when BCl3, boron trichloride, is directly reacted with hydrogen gas in silent electric discharge. Silent electric discharge means by passage of current. So passage of current, that gives B2H6 plus 6HCl. So it is a diborane preparation. B2H6 plus 6HCl. Next and last preparation method, that is when B2O3, boron trioxide, reacts with hydrogen gas in the presence of aluminium metal. So at about 750 atmospheres pressure, 750, please note down, 750 atmospheres pressure, high pressure. So that gives B2H6 plus Al2O3 is the production. Al2O3 is the production. So this is the way to prepare diborane. Okay. 6LiH. Yes. 6LiH. Okay. Correct. So these are preparation methods of diborane. Every reaction is important. So please try to by heart. Try to memorize. No other option. Everything is in. Okay. So now this is the preparation methods of diborane. Next, what are the properties of diborane? That is,
properties and diborane, it is a gas, colorless gas and highly toxic gas, that is a poisonous gas. So see here, that is first point, it is a colorless highly toxic gas. So diborane is a colorless highly toxic gas, highly toxic gas. Okay, next point, on long standing, okay, so it decomposes, it decomposes into higher higher boranes. On long standing, it decomposes into higher boranes. See here, that is, so B2H6, I am taking two times, that gives B4H10 plus H2N. It is higher borane. So lower borane, diborane is converted into higher borane. So on long standing. Next, third point. So it is unstable. In the presence of grease and moisture. It is unstable in the presence of grease and moisture. Okay, so very, very important. So that means in the absence of grease and moisture, it is very, very stable. So in the absence of grease and moisture, it is very, very stable. It is unstable in the presence. Okay, next, fourth point, and very, very, very important. So that is a combustion reaction. That is action of air. Action of air, which is nothing but combustion. Okay, so combustion wise, action of air, which is also called as combustion, burning in the presence of excess of oxygen. So that is action of air, combustion. So that is, see here, and diborane B2H6 is on strong heating in the presence of oxygen, that gives B2O3 plus H2O is the product. Along this, a huge amount of heat energy will be released. It is exothermic reaction wise. Similarly, let us observe. So that is B4H10. B4H10. That is a tetraborane. When it reacts with oxygen, that one also gives B2O3. It is solid wise. It is also solid. And H2O, along with large heat energy released. A huge amount of heat is released, boys. Very, very high amount heat energy is released. So, boys, it is tetraborane. That means, so tetraborane 10 releases very, very high amount of energy. That is why that heat energy is utilized for further purpose. That is why that this tetraborane is used as a fuel. Just like, please wait. I'm comparing this value with C4H10. C4H10, right? It is butane. Butane used in cooking gas. No doubt as a fuel. So used in cooking gas as a fuel wise. If it is combustion, because why you are taking? It is B4H10, it is C4H10. It is organic, it is inorganic. So is on combustion gives CO2 gas plus H2O also in the form of gas. So heat energy is produced.
This released heat energy is used as a fuel. That means, so when compared to C4H10 butane, large amount of heat energy is released in case of tetraborate. That means, which is better fuel, boys? Which is better fuel? Is C4H10 or B4H10? Which is better fuel? C4H10 or B4H10? Tell me. Which gives large amount of heat energy? No doubt, B4H10. B4H10. That means, so B4H10 is a better fuel than that of C4H10. So B4H10, therefore, B4H10 is better fuel than C4H10. But the only drawback is, this is a solid form, boys. If in cylinders, if this gas is used, the solid is precipitated. So that solid gives a dangerous situation. Because of that reason, it is not used in your cylinder. Because there is a solid, impurity is separate out. But here, CO2 gas escaped from cylinder and entered into the environment. That means no one is inside the cylinder after completion of that gas. So that is why we are using only butane, but not tetraborane. Because of this drawback. So B4H10 is better fuel than C4H10, but it gives solid B2O3. But it gives a solid B2O3. It is not possible to separate. So that is why it is not used. But the reactions are very, very important. Boys, I am using unbalanced equations. We should balance these. Okay. This is about the reaction of oxygen, the diborane with oxygen or combustion reaction. Some other reactions. All those reactions are also important. See here, other reactions at one place at a glance. B2H6 diborane reacts with different reagents. First reaction with water that gives H3BO3 plus hydrogen gas is evolved. H3BO3 plus hydrogen gas is evolved. So when diborane reacts with water, that gives boric acid and liberates hydrogen gas. Next, reaction with KOH plus water, that gives KBO2, potassium borate, metaborate. Potassium metaborate and liberates hydrogen gas. Potassium metaborate and liberates hydrogen gas when it reacts with KOH or NaOH like compounds. Next, when it reacts with methyl alcohol, formula CH3OH. When it reacts with methyl alcohol, boys, this reaction, so in 2015 advance appeared butane. This reaction. See here. So when it reacts with methyl alcohol, that gives BOCH3 thrice plus hydrogen gas. Here also hydrogen gas is liberated. Next, it is advanced 2015 butane. Check your answers. Next, when it reacts with HCl, so in the presence of AlCl3. So AlCl3 is the catalyst, boys. Reaction with HCl in the presence of AlCl3. If it is HBr in the presence of AlBr3. Like that. So all these hydrogens are replaced, boys. So see here. When it reacts with HCl,
First of all, just a minute. Only one of the hydrogen is replaced, that is B2H5Cl is the product. When it reacts with HCl, the product is B2H5ClNe. So this H plus H, hydrogen gas is liberated. Here also hydrogen gas liberated. So hydrogen gas liberated. Here, order of reactivity. Order of reactivity ending. HCl less than HBr less than HIN. Order of reactivity, HCl less than HBr less than HIN. Next, when it reacts with chlorine, when it reacts with chlorine, okay, at about 25 degrees centigrade room temperature, the reaction takes place. All these hydrogens are replaced, any? All these hydrogens are replaced, that gives BCl3 plus HCl is the product, any? Not H2OH. BCl3 plus HCl. Next, when it reacts with Br2, only one hydrogen is replaced, B2H5Br plus HCl. When it reacts with I2, no reaction, boys. That means here all hydrogens are replaced. Here only one hydrogen is replaced. Here almost no reaction. Now what is the reactivity? Order of reactivity is Cl2 greater than Br2 greater than I2. Cl2 greater than Br2 greater than I2. Okay. So these are very, very important reactions, boys. These are very, very important reactions. Next, reaction with carbon monoxide. Reaction with carbon monoxide. Addition reaction takes place, boys. That gives 2BH3CO. Addition compound is possible. 2BH3CO addition component. So between carbon monoxide and BH3, there is a coordinate covalent bonding. So later I will explain it. Next, when it reacts with Na2HG, amalgam, Na2HG, sodium amalgam, that gives addition component B2H6Na2HG. Na2HG, it is addition component. So addition compound is prominent. Very, very, very important reactions. Next, when it reacts with alkyl halide, that means out of six hydrogens are replaced, but not two hydrogens. See here, that is B2H2 tetraalkyl plus, so 4HXN. So 4 moles involved in the reaction, boys. So the B2H, it is 4 times. B2H2 are 4 times plus 4HX is the product. That means only 4 hydrogens are replaced. That means in diborane, there are 6 hydrogens. Among all those 6 hydrogens, 4 are one type. And 2 are another type. And that means all 6 hydrogens in diborane are not identical. All hydrogens in diborane are not identical. 2 types of hydrogens are there. So 2 types of hydrogens are there. See here. With boron, bromine, this is the product wise. Only one hydrogen is replaced. With chlorine, 3 hydrogens. All hydrogens are replaced. So all hydrogens are replaced. Okay, here BCl3 is the product, but here, so bromodiborate, yes, okay. So these are all some reactions. These are all some reactions towards diborane, boys. And most important reaction, reaction with ammonia, subheading. Reaction with ammonia. That is very, very, very important.
reaction with ammonia. Reaction with ammonia. What is the reaction? Very, very important reaction is, so see here, that is when diborane reacts with 2 moles ammonia, it is heated up to 120 degrees centigrade, gives B2H6 2NH3N. Addition compound is productive. An addition compound is formed. So 2 ammonia, diborane, all are added, addition compound is formed. What is the name? That is diammoniate of diborane. Diammoniate of diborane. It is the name of that compound. It is addition compound boys. Still it is heated. It is up to 200 degrees centigrade. Still it is heated up to 200 degrees centigrade. That gives an important compound of B3N3H6 and hydrogen gas is evolved. B3N3H6. This B3N3H6 is called as borazole or borazine or borazane. Z-A-N-E. Or inorganic benzene. So inorganic benzene. Frequently these two words are used. Right? Borazole or inorganic benzene is the product name. Borazole or inorganic benzene. Its formula B3N3H6. Because its structure is similar to benzene, that's why it is called as inorganic benzene. That is in organic chemistry, it is in inorganic chemistry, that's why it is called as inorganic benzene. Later, tomorrow we will discuss about this borazole voice. Now still it is heated. Greater than 200 degrees centigrade. So remaining hydrogen is also lost. Any boron with hydrogen, boron with nitrogen, boron nitride is the product end, n times polymer end. Boron nitride is the product and hydrogen gas is evolved. So at different temperatures, different products. Up to 120 degrees centigrade, addition product. Up to 200 degrees centigrade, borazole end. So greater than 200 degrees centigrade, boron nitride. So these are all very, very important compounds. So when diborane reacts with ammonia. Sir, what is the mechanism of this reaction? How these are formed? So I will explain why. So before going to that, one more reaction. So it is first, second one. That is, when B2H6 diborane reacts with ammonia in 1:2 ratio, in 1:2 ratio, and heated up to 250 degrees centigrade, that gives B3N3H6. Same compound is available. B3N3H6. Borazole is the product. Now, what is the mechanism? What is the reaction behind this equation? So now, how bonds are cleaved in diborane? Now, our topic is bond cleavages in diborane. Types of bond cleavages in diborane. There, I am going to explain how these reactions are takes place. Okay? So, submitting types of bond cleavages. Cleavage means breaking end. So, types of bond cleavages in diborane. Very, very important. Very, very important. See here. Types of bond cleavages in diborane boys. types of bond cleavages in diborase. Here two types of cleavages possible. One is symmetric cleavage and the other one is asymmetric cleavage. See here what happened. So at the time of banana bond, we discussed the structure of diborane is a bridge-like structure. So tomorrow we will discuss about the structure. Now I am using structure. So that is, this is the structure of diborane. This is diborane. So next, one more I am trying to explain. Next. This is diborane. Okay. So one is symmetric cleavage and the other one is unsymmetrical cleavage. So that means, see here. Here bonds are cleaved here like this side. If these two bonds are cleaved, what happened? It is unequal bond breaking. Unequal shearing is there. So therefore it is unsymmetric cleavage. It is unsymmetric cleavage. It is unsymmetric cleavage. Otherwise here, see, observe. If bond is broken like this, so these two bonds are going to break. So this is BH3, that is BH3. Equal parts are coming out. That is a symmetric cleavage. This is unsymmetric cleavage. That is a symmetric cleavage. These two cleavages are possible, boys. So when this happened, depending on the groups attached, ligands, bases attached to this diborane. So these different cleavages are possible. See here. This cleavage with first one, ammonia. When ammonia involved in the reaction, ammonia and nitrogen has a lone pair bias. So if this ammonia involved, this is the type of cleavage. Lighter molecules. Second one, water. If water involved in the reaction, this type of cleavage is possible. So this is also base. Okay. Next, third one, that is a primary amines. Primary amines, nothing but RNAH2 group. Nitrogen has a lone pair. Here also, this cleavage is possible. Next, fourth one, secondary amines. That is, this example, for this example is CH3NH2, methylamine. Example. R2NH. It is a secondary amine. So it is for this example, CH3 twice NH. So CH3 twice NH3. In presence of ammonia, water, primary amines, or secondary amines, all these leads to unsymmetric cleavage. I will explain with mechanism. Please wait. Next, here symmetric cleavage, when it is possible, here this is with first one. Here primary amines, secondary amines are completed. Here bulky groups are, particularly bulky groups. So whenever bulky groups are there, symmetric cleavage takes place. It is a simple groups. So simple groups, those are bulky groups. In the presence of bulky groups, symmetric cleavage is possible. One is tertiary amine. That is example, that is R3NN. Example for that, CH3 thrice NN. CH3 thrice N, that is a tertiary amine. That is a bulky group, boys. In the presence of bulky group, symmetric cleavage is available. Next, second one. That is a pyridine. That is a pyridine. Formula C5H5N. Nitrogen has lone pair. Its structure is like this. So its structure is benzene-like structure, but one of the corners is a nitrogen. Benzene-like structure. Okay, that is a pyridine. That is a pyridine. So that is also bulky. That is also bulky. Next, with carbon monoxide. It is a bulky, strong ligand. Next, with
dimethyl ether. That is ether sand. With the trimethyl, that is dimethyl thioethers, sulfur end. Dimethyl thioethers. Next. So, sixth one, that is Na2HG in the presence of amalgams. That is also conditionally. Next. I'm writing here. So, that is a pyridine derivative. Right? Pyridine derivative. So, methyl group. So, in the presence of this group also, because that one also bulky. Pyridine bulky, automatically substituted pyridine also bulky. In the presence of these bulky groups, symmetric cleavage is there. So, in the presence of simple groups, so unsymmetric cleavage is there. So, what are the products? What is the mechanism of this reaction? Let us explain one by one. See here. Boys, note all these points. Very, very, very important. First of all, I'm explaining unsymmetric cleavage. In this unsymmetric cleavage, so what are the products formed? Here, see here, BH2 plus ion, BH4 minus ion form. This is BH2, this is BH4. BH2 plus BH4 minus ionic compound is the product. Ionic compounds. In case of unsymmetrical cleavage, ionic compounds are the products. But in case of symmetric case cleavage, covalent compounds are the products. It is ionic compound. So let us explain the structure. See here. So if diborane reacts with ammonia, that is a simple one. So because of this lone pair. So first of all, one of this bond is going to break. This lone pair is donated to this boron. So that gives boron with hydrogen, bridge hydrogen, boron. So everything is normal. But here, so a D2 bond is formed with that ammonia with NH there. It is first ammonia molecule. So it is possible. Next, one more ammonia I am adding it. Second one. Here also this bond is going to break. This lone pair is also donated to the because boron has 4 is the coordination. That's why 2 ammonias are attached with coordinate covalent bonds. So therefore, boron with hydrogen. Next. NH3, overall it is a plus. Next, BH4. Minus is formed. BH4 minus is formed. So this is the way how ammonia is involved in the reaction. This is the addition compound, boys. This is the addition compound. This is ionic compound. It is nothing but B2H6 2NH3. It is ionic compound. Now, what type of bonds are there? Here, between these two, ionic bond is there. Here, a coordinate covalent bond is there. Here, covalent bonds are there. So that means covalent bond available, D2 bond, that is coordinate covalent bond available, ionic bond. So all these three types of bonds are possible. So this is diammonia diborane. So it is additional compound. So here, unsymmetrical cleavage is available. Ionic compound is the product. Okay? Did you catch this concept, boys? Very, very, very important. Not only ammonia, water, or something else. With lighter molecules, this type of reactions are possible. Okay. Next, with symmetric cation. See here. with I am using a tertiary amine boys. See here. So boron, this is diborane boys. When it reacts with a tertiary amine, reacts with a tertiary amine nitrogen with the 3 methyl groups, triacyl. It is a tertiary amine. So tertiary amine, that is a trimethyl, trimethyl amine. It is the name of that compound. Trimethyl amine, it is an example to a tertiary amine. See here, first of all, this bond is going to be break. This bond is going to be break. This lone pair is donated to this boron. That lone pair is donated to this boron. Now, what is the product? See here. That is boron, hydrogen, 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 boron, hydrogens with hydrogen. So now here a coordinate covalent bond NCH3 thrice is formed. Why? Because of this bulkiness, this area is totally covered with this group. That's why further nitrogenous compound is not coming this side. So now it is possible. So now it is in this direction. So therefore, now I am using one more molecule. NCH3 thrice. It is the second one. So now, so because it is bulkiness, not possible. So it is going to be break. This is going to be break. This lone pair is attached to this boron. Lone pair is attached to that boron. See here. That is boron, hydrogen, 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 CH3 with nitrogen with CH3 thrice. So it is a covalent compound. Why? So this one also is same. That's why two molecules of this compound is formed. Two molecules of that compound. So a covalent bond is formed, covalent molecule entity. So this contains no ionic bonds, only coordinate covalent and covalent bonds are positive. Only coordinate covalent and covalent bonds are positive. Okay. So altogether, simply we are writing this compound like this. So that is 2BH3. I'm writing just a minute. So it is 2 moles. So BH3. So NCH3 thrice. So these two are same. These two are same boys. Okay. So it is the simplest way to represent that molecule, boys. Only it is a covalent molecule. It is a covalent molecule. Covalent molecule, boys. So this is the cleavages that is happen in diborane. So in case of simple compounds, so asymmetric cleavage is possible because same side cleavage is possible. Any in case of bulkiness, so same side attack is not possible. Opposite side, that is why symmetric cleavage is possible. So like this, so different types of cleavages are possible in case of diborane. Okay, tomorrow we will discuss about the structure of diborane and some other compounds of diborane. Okay.